Good morning, kids. Last week, we had a great final lesson in the armor of God. Today, we are starting a new series on Psalm 23. Do you guys know what the book of Psalms is? It's a really big book in the Bible that has 150 psalms in it. These psalms are like songs. They are sung with music. Maybe you have heard of Psalm 23 because it is very well known. It talks about how God is our shepherd. So today, we are learning that God guides us. In Psalm 23, verse 1, it says, "The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need." God is our shepherd. And what do shepherds do? They guide sheep, right? They make sure that the sheep have all that they need. Do you guys remember David from the Bible? The one who defeated Goliath and then later became king? Well, he was a shepherd, and he is the one who wrote Psalm 23. So from all of his experience guiding sheep as a shepherd, he sees how God guides him. In Psalm 23, David compares God to the shepherd and us to the sheep. In the book of John, Jesus talks about how he is the good shepherd. Let me read for you what Jesus says. "Very truly, I tell you, Pharisees, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way, is a thief and a robber. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice." Here, Jesus is talking about shepherds and sheep and how sheep know their shepherd. They follow the shepherd because they know him. And guess what? God knows us and loves us. He cares for each one of us and guides us. We know that because Jesus says this just a few verses later. "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays his life down for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep." That was a long verse, but Jesus says that he is the good shepherd. He cares for us and protects us because he loves us. It says that he knows us and that if we are his sheep, we know him. That's why we want to learn more about who God is. It also says that the good shepherd lays his life down for his sheep. Does that sound familiar? That's the Easter story. Jesus loves us so much that he died on the cross for our sins. That's why Jesus is the good shepherd. And Jesus is with us to guide us as his sheep every day, giving us all that we need. Let's go talk to Jimmy and Mr. Alfred. Who's that making noise in the cookie section? Jimmy, is that you?
Jerry, where are you?
Jimmy, who are you looking for? And who's Jerry?
Oh, hi, Mr. Alfred. Jerry is my pet sheep. I got him after Pastor Joel was teaching us about shepherds. I thought I'd give it a try.
Oh boy. And can I ask why?
Why not?
Do you know anything about sheep?
Not really. Just what Pastor Joel told me. What kind of cookies do you think he likes? Chocolate chip? Oatmeal? White chocolate macadamia nut? Oreos?
I think he would probably like some grass, not cookies. You have a lot to learn, Jimmy.
Well, Pastor Joel told me about how Jesus is the good shepherd and how he loves us and cares for us. It sounds so easy for God to do that, but then I got Jerry. He runs away from people he doesn't know, including me. I have to chase him everywhere.
Oh no! How you feel is how God must feel when we try doing life on our own. God guides his sheep, but when we sin, it's like we run away. But even when that happens, God protects and guides his sheep because he knows them.
Yeah. Maybe soon Jerry will know me. That way I can guide him like God guides me.
Yeah, hopefully. And then when he knows you, you can guide him and he will follow you, just how God guides us. But we need to choose to follow him.
This has really shown me how good of a shepherd Jesus is. Jerry is too much work for me. I am not a perfect shepherd. If someone were to come and steal him, I might just let him have him.
I bet he is a lot of work. But that's not what Jesus does with us, right? He protects us and guards us as he guides us through life. He is a perfect shepherd, even though you are not.
You bet. Well, maybe Jerry will get to know me if I feed him some more cookies. Cookies, cookies, cookies.
Thanks, Jimmy and Mr. Alfred. Crazy Jimmy, but you guys don't need to go get a sheep, okay? Jesus is the good shepherd, and he guides us each and every day as we go through life. He loves us so much that he was willing to die so that we could be saved. That is so cool, because we don't deserve it at all. But because Jesus is the good shepherd, he guides us like a shepherd guides his sheep. I hope you have a great week. But first, let me close with a joke. What does a sheep say before he leaves someone? Bye!